Roman Jewish Catholic community, but it's back to renew his friendship with us. And so we welcome him, and we thank him for being with us today. So welcome, Mike.
And children of the congregation, come forward.
Some days are just like today, where it's a happy day, it's Harvest Sunday,
We've got cucumbers, we've got pumpkins, we've got grits, we've got stuff to be happy about, and we sing happy songs in church today. And we're telling God, thanks for everything, this is wonderful. And God says, well, thanks for telling me, I'm glad that you appreciate everything. So you can go down to Sunday school and hear about all the good stuff that God has in store for us. Thanks for being here.
Is that a green? Is that a green?
That's great.
Come on.
A reading from the book of Jeremiah. My joy is gone, grief is upon me, my heart is sick. Hark, the cry of my poor people from far and wide in the land. Is the Lord not in Zion? Is a king not in Judah? Why have they provoked me to anger with their images, their foreign idols? The harvest is past. The summer is ended, and we are not saved. For the hurt of my people, I am hurt. I mourn, and dismay has taken hold of me. Is there no balm in Gilead? Is there no physician there? Why then has the health of my people not been restored? Oh, that my head were a spring of water, and my eyes a fountain of tears, so that I might weep day and night for the slain of my poor people. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm is Psalm 79. And we'll say it responsively. I'll say the first verse, the congregation the next, and so on. O God, the heathen have come into your inheritance. They have profaned your holy temple. They have made Jerusalem a heap of rubble.
They have given the bodies of your servants as food for the birds of the air, and the flesh of your faithful ones to the beasts of the field.
They have shed their blood like water on every side of Jerusalem, and there is no one to bury them.
We have become an armor of worship to our neighbours, and objects of scorn and derision to those around us.
How long will you be angry, O Lord? Will your fury blaze like fire forever? Pour out your wrath on them. For they have devoured Jacob and made his way in ruin.
Remember God our past sins, that your compassion be swift to meet us, for we have been brought very low.
Help us, O God our Saviour, for the glory of your name. Deliver us and forgive us our sins, for your name's sake. And together.
Gracious God, in times of sorrow and depression, when the Holy Spirit seems lost, help us to remember. A reading from the first letter of Paul to Timothy. First of all, then, I urge the supplications, prayers, intercessions, and thanksgivings be made for everyone, for kings and all who are in high positions, so that we may lead a quiet and peaceable life in all godliness and dignity. This is right and is acceptable in the sight of God our Savior, who desires everyone to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. For there is one God, there is one mediator between God and humankind, Christ Jesus, himself human, who gave himself a ransom for all, that was attested at the right time. For this I was appointed a herald and an apostle. I am telling the truth, I'm not lying. A teacher of the Gentiles, in faith and truth. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Then Jesus said to the disciples, there was a rich man who had a manager, and charges were brought to him that this man was squandering his property. So he summoned him and said to him, what is this that I hear about you? Give me an accounting of your management, because you cannot be my manager any longer. Then the manager said to himself, what will I do now that my master is taking the position away from me? I am not strong enough to dig, and I am ashamed to beg. I have decided what to do, so that when I am dismissed as manager, people may welcome me into their homes. So, summoning his master's debtors one by one, he asked the first, how much do you owe my master? He answered, 100 jugs of olive oil. He said to him, take your bill, sit down quickly, and make it 50. Then he asked another, how much do you owe? He replied, 100 containers of wheat. He said to him, take your bill and make it 80. And his master commended the dishonest manager because he had acted shrewdly. For the children of this age are more shrewd in dealing with their own generation than are the children of light. And I tell you, make friends for yourselves by means of dishonest wealth, so that when it is gone, they may welcome you into the eternal homes. Whoever is faithful in a very little is faithful also in much. And whoever is dishonest in a very little is dishonest also in much. If you have been faithful with dishonest wealth, who will entrust you with the true riches? And if you have not been faithful with what belongs to another, who will give you what is your own? No slave can serve two masters, for a slave will either hate the one and love the other, or be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and wealth. The Gospel of Christ.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We pray. O God, remember not our past sins. Let your compassion be swift to meet us. Amen. One Thursday, a number of years ago, just before we moved here to Dryden, I had worship at the Langenberg Care Home, that's in eastern Saskatchewan. Hilda Welke faithfully played for us and picked the hymns. Familiar tunes. Hilda told me Thursday on the phone that Thursday was her son Ronald's 67th birthday and wanted to dedicate the service to him. She had phoned Ron and asked, what's your favorite hymn? Beautiful Savior. At Hilda's age, her repertoire had become somewhat limited. I don't recall her playing Beautiful Savior for a very long time. She said she'd have to practice. Thursday morning, Hilda played, and we sang all four verses of Beautiful Savior. She must have practiced hard because she hit every note just right and played with gusto. Except at the end of the fourth verse, she played a fifth. That's not too uncommon for an organist, is it? It's not uncommon for Hilda to miss a verse. We just quit singing or play an extra. We wait patiently. I just hope I do half as well when I'm her age, if I live that long. But Hilda played a sixth and seventh verse of Beautiful Savior. Then an eighth verse. Val, the program director, took it in stride, marched over, and after Hilda played yet a ninth verse, Val said loudly, "Thank you, Hilda!" And she quit. Such a performance was highly unusual for Hilda. But you know, watching her, I thought, she's so intent and intense on playing for her son's birthday. She so wants to do this just right. She loves that boy of hers so much, she's completely forgot where she's at. It's not uncommon for a mother to lose herself in her children, or for that matter, a father. What we will come to know this morning is that God actually loses God's self in us. God plays the tune of life and faith for us so intently that even God is overwhelmed. Have you not lost yourself in the heat of living, consumed by a task, so absorbed in work you lose all track of time? It's easy to forget yourself in the line of duty, or even a hobby. Life is demanding. Think of a college grad starting that first year of teaching. All the lessons to prepare, tests, meetings. There's little time left for anything else. A new mom or dad with a baby. Boy, when Christy was born, did that ever change things? Then along came Katie. I often wonder what it was like raising five or six kids. How about a dozen? And back when families were big, there were no dishwashers, no cameras, no microwaves. The days everything was done by hand. With all the labor-saving devices we got, where does the time go? You get up, you breakfast, get busy with the day, and all of a sudden it's bedtime. Where did they go? The day? The week? How about the years? Where did they go? We get too soon old and too late smart, so the Germans would put it in the last parish. When our girls were young, I asked a few retired pastors what they'd do different. They all told me I'd spend more time with the family. Too soon old and too late smart. How many parents regret the busyness of younger years, the kids too soon gone, and feeling like you never really got to know them all that well? Thank God for the grandkids. But what choice do we really have? Raising kids is demanding. Teaching is consuming. There's no end to work on a farm. Would you want it any different? I look back over 40 years of ministry. I regret not having weekends off to do things with my girls when they were in school. Yet would I want a job where I punched a time card at 8 in the morning and 4 in the afternoon? How about you farmers? I know the farm economy at times stinks, but would you have preferred work in Winnipeg? Parents, would you give up your kids? We get so busy playing the tune of life, love, and faith, we forget ourselves. Besides, in that distressingly difficult gospel reading, it seems Jesus tells us to make the most of that long list of everyday little things. Because if we can't manage the stuff of daily life, how will we ever manage heaven? If that weren't bad enough, we also forget ourselves in the heat of sin. For we do not always do a good job at living life. You know that? I know that. Prophet and psalmist this morning know it too. Last Sunday and today were taken to task. Well, truth be told, it's the people of Israel who get it. God says, why have they provoked me to anger with their images and idols? There's a story about Moses on the mountain with God. Clouds and thunder, 10 commandments written in stone, all the while the people of Israel down at the bottom, patiently waiting for Moses. Time goes by. They get impatient. They forget God and have Aaron take all their gold and forge a golden calf to worship. Better the idol we see than the God we don't. Prophet and psalmist take Israel to task for idolatry. We too forget God. Now, you may not have a gold idol sitting at home, but who here does not listen to other voices? How can you live in this society and not worship books? Think of the time we spend primping in the morning, trimming a beard. It used to be only women had their hair and nails done and body hair removed. No more. I grew up in the days when men had hair. Hairy arms, hairy chest, hairy face. In junior high, I couldn't wait till I could grow sideburns. Guys, they get their chests waxed. Bunch of mints. We think so much of ourselves, we actually forget ourselves. That is our real self. It all gets to be show, pretense. We pretend to be other than what we are. We no longer like the real self as we try to imitate Google ads or TV. Funny how we hate being human. And that's when God takes offense. When we fail to appreciate the small stuff, the real stuff, the stuff of self, family, friends, and community. We forget what life is all about. Why is it the Canadian dream is to have a comfy life and not be bothered by anybody else? Live on an acreage and not have neighbors. Who's got time for anybody? I don't even have time for myself. Idolatry. The world right now worships idols, confusing God and country. I know Americans do that. The American flag ranks right up there with God. We Canadians love to find fault with the American system, as if all is well here in planet Canada. Life's a boxing ring with radical Muslims, fundamentalist Christians, all contending for the world title. Don't try and tell me we haven't forgotten God. We've lost sight of God in the heap of sin. God. Well, God keeps playing the tune. Sitting at the piano, God plays for the children God loves so well. It's a broken-hearted love song. God sings, my joy is gone, my heart is broke. You ever been heartsick for a son or a daughter? What parent hasn't? We are what I call paranoid. We worry endlessly, sometimes needlessly, for our children. We know what the world's like. We grew up in it too. We know the pitfalls. We know the younger generation will have to find their way in this world. Still, we worry and we do what we can. So God worries over us. God sings, oh, that my head were a spring of water and my eyes a fountain of tears, so that I might weep day and night for my children. But God also does what God can. God doesn't take adversity laying down. Last Sunday, we heard in the Gospel, or in the second reading, Jesus Christ came into the world to save sinners. And that's good news. Everybody here qualifies. No one banned. All can come to worship here. It's been another hectic week. We've done the best we could under the circumstances. Harvest, students back to school. Life is a never-ending merry-go-round. God playing the tune above all this discord and dismay. Voices, good and bad, all cry for our attention. Sometimes we listen and dance to the wrong tune. So God plays louder yet. In the heat of living, in the heat of sinning, we've forgotten God. Did you remember all week that Jesus Christ came into the world to save sinners, you and me included? I got busy. I had a big week. I forgot. In case we forget, God plays louder yet. A tune called, God Desires Everyone to Be Saved and to Come to the Knowledge of the Truth. To know God, just as we know parent and child, neighbor and friend. We're told this morning, for there is one God, there is also one mediator between us and God, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for all. At best, that's how we live our lives, by giving ourselves to the people who matter most. Not just family, not just community, not just country, but to all the world. For this is what God does. God sits at the piano and plays for all. Sometimes in anguish, putting God's heart into it, never quitting, never forgetting, God plays on. Let us confess the faith of our baptism as we say.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, the only Son of our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate. Was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended to heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Congregations of the Southern Interior Region of British Columbia. In the Diocese of Rupert's Land, we pray for Jeff, our diocesan bishop, and the congregations of St. Matthew, Winnipeg, St. Matthew, Cloverdale, and St. Matthew on the Pegasus Reserve. In our power cycle of prayer, we pray for Art and Shelley Ralston, Pat and Reg Russell, Curtis and Lori Russell. And we give thanks that Reverend Michael Bergman is here to join us this Sunday. We give thanks for the people who donated time and items to make our church look so beautiful for this Harvest Thanksgiving service, and to all the volunteers who assist with different events throughout St. Luke's. Father, we give you thanks for your love and forgiveness. Teach us to forgive as you have forgiven us, to be merciful, and yet to maintain justice. We pray for all penitents and all who seek forgiveness. Lord, guide all who are spiritual counselors and confessors. We pray for all who lead retreats and who look after conference centers. Help us, O Lord our God.
Save us from the glory of your name.
We ask you to strengthen and guide all who are in position of trust, all in places of authority, all who make decisions concerning our future. We pray for integrity and fair dealing in world trade, that no one is counted as cheap labor. We remember all who are impoverished, all who cry for justice, all who work for freedom and dignity. Help us, O Lord our God.
Save us from the glory of your name.
We give thanks for all you have given to us. We ask you to bless our homes and families with your presence, love, and peace. We pray for homes where there is unrest, fearfulness, and violence. For all who have suffered abuse or neglect. For children taken into care. Help us, O Lord our God.
Save us from the glory of your name.
Loving God, even the sparrow has found a home, and the swallow a nest for herself, where she places her young near your altar. You are attentive to all you have made. Help us provide refuge for every animal and plant with whom we live. When Jesus cried out and gave up his spirit, the earth shook and the rocks split. You are known by the whole of creation that listens to you. Help us hear and know you just as the earth and rocks do. Help us to learn from the way in which we see creation. Recognize your glorious beauty. Loving God, you are present in the creation and seek to heal her wounds. You can be found walking in the garden. Open our eyes to see you as the gardener. Help us, O Lord, our God.
Save us, O Lord, our God.
We remember before you all whose wounds find no cure. We pray for the chronically ill, for all who suffer from schizophrenia, all who are deeply distressed, any who are troubled in body, mind, or spirit. We remember loved ones who are ill at this time. Penny Bruegel, Haley Shute, Bill Laundrie, Brian Reed, Sharon Robinson, and Rick Victor. Help us, O God, our Lord.
Save us from your name.
We give thanks for all who have triumphed over the troubles of this world and all who are now at rest and at peace in your kingdom. We pray for friends and loved ones departed from us. Help us, O Lord, our God.
Save us from your name.
Loving God, who hears every voice, knows each cry of injustice, and is attentive to suffering of the earth, teach us to listen. Bring healing to our lives, that we may protect the world and not prey on it. that we may listen to the world you have created and not close ourselves from it. Reveal to us the ways in which we have failed to hear your voice in how we treat the earth. Holy God, as you have called us to serve you, guide us and make us worthy of your calling. Give us wisdom to use our talents and resources to your glory and the benefit of all who are in need. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Dear friends in Christ, God is steadfast and often infinite in mercy. God welcomes sinners and invites them to God's table. Let us confess our sins, confident in God's forgiveness. God of power, the glory of your works fills us with wonder and awe. Accept our offering this day and help us to live in peace and harmony with all your creation for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We break this bread to share the body of Christ.
We eat it again.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Ruler of the universe, all creation yearns for its fulfillment in your Son. May we who have shared in holy things grow into maturity in Him. This we ask in the name of the same Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Altar guild ladies for their dedication to serve our Lord and church. Harvest Sunday. We at St. Luke's have a lot to be thankful. Thank you, God.
I noticed there was a mistake in the bulletin after I just sent it out. The last service at Minnetaki is September, not August. September 25th.
Go ahead.
Yeah, just wanted to see your bulletins. Make sure you read right to the end. Starting the fourth Sunday of each month, we're going to have a service following our 9:30. We're going to do an 11 o'clock. So anybody that's having a struggle to get up and get here for 9:30 in the morning, if you know of anybody, then the service fourth Sunday of each month will have an 11 o'clock service. And there won't be any music at it, but it'll be 11 o'clock service followed by a little light lunch after. So keep that in mind. If anybody that's told you that they're struggling to get up for 9:30, there's an 11 o'clock service, fourth Sunday of each month.
And I want to thank everybody who helped at the garage sale yesterday. We made $545. Yay! And thank you to everybody for all the help. I greatly appreciate it. And thank you. Our closing hymn is